AMD's new Ryzen 3000 series has been doing very well, as we have also seen in my 3950X and 3970X review. And with the new Ryzen 3 3100 and 3300X, the excellent scalability of the series is now available in a more affordable package. The 3100 and 3300X look very similar on the spec sheet, but they have a different layout of cores which makes the 3300X perform better. But today we are also going to test it against the 3600 to see whether spending the extra 6000 rupees is worth it, especially for gaming. For this test, we have the latest B550 Tough board from ASUS, which offers some really nice features for its price, along with its clever use of heatsinks doubling up as I/O cover. But we tested everything with an ASUS X570 Prime motherboard because there was suddenness in this move and there was no warning to ASUS that we were not going to use the B550 board for anything. So let's jump right into the benchmarks with gaming. In Shadow of the Tomb Raider, we see the 3300X and 3600 performing closely, with the 3100 lagging significantly behind. Then in CSGO, we see a similar story, which further shows how much of a difference having all 4 cores on the same CCX makes for the 3300X. In Borderlands 3, we see the 3300X matching well with 3600 again, and the 3100 is left behind, further limited by its lower clock speed compared to the 3300X. Then finally in Rainbow Six Siege, we are already getting very high FPS, but there is still a significant difference between these CPUs. So it is clear that the 3300X is close to 3600 purely for gaming, but the story changes a lot when we come to productivity tasks. Cinebench R20 scales very well with cores and clock speeds, and here we see the raw difference in performance between the 3100 and 3300X. In Cinebench single core benchmark, we see the 3300X outperforming even the 3600 due to its higher clock speed. And then in Blender BMW Render, we realize that there is a big performance difference between the 3600 and 3300X. Adobe Premiere results surprised us a lot, as we see a really big difference between the quad-core and the hexa-core CPUs, and this really makes the 3600 a much better choice if you are planning to edit videos. Then in V-Ray, we again see how better the 3600 is for productivity tasks. And then in POV Ray, all these CPUs scale almost identically as our V-Ray result. 7-zip decompression continues to show that the lower core count CPUs are really not that great for productivity workloads, and the story doesn't change when we switch to compression. Finally, coming to the power consumption, we see the 9900K showing chart-topping numbers from the opposite side, but it is really great to see how efficient these Ryzen chips are, and you are not going to see a significant difference in your electricity bill between these three Ryzen CPUs. So the Ryzen 3100 costs 8400 rupees, and the Ryzen 3300 costs around 11000 rupees, and the Ryzen 5 3600 costs around 17000 rupees. So the question is, which to go for? So while the 3100 delivered more than 60 FPS in the games we tested, I still think that it is worth spending 2700 rupees more, because you are getting significantly better performance, and in the overall cost of the build, 2700 rupees isn't a big difference. Then the 3300X is a really excellent chip for a gaming PC on a budget, because you are getting performance that is close to Ryzen 5 3600, and considering that you will probably not be pairing it with an RTX 2080 Ti, you will be limited with your GPU. So if you are only gaming and you don't have extra cash to spare for the multitasking abilities of 3600, the 3300X is a perfect choice. Then finally, the 3600 is just an excellent all-rounder CPU at a really great price. Not only it can deliver an amazing value for money for gaming, it can also handle the productivity workloads well. And while it is of course not going to provide Threadripper levels of performance, it can be a great option for tasks like video editing on a budget. So that was it for this short video. For more details, you can watch videos by people who have much longer hair than me. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Share your thoughts in the comment section below. Subscribe with bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.